Welcome back. This is Market Fatafat. Let's move right on then. Now we've got everything sorted. Let's flag off those buzzing stocks in trade. HPCL is up to its winning ways. Let's just talk a little bit about what the quarter gone by was and, of course, implication of crude oil prices. Pranay, to you.
Well, Avan, it was known that the numbers won't be strong. So even Deutsche Bank has said that operationally as well as the bottom line turned out to be much lower than even muted expectations. While the stock may have corrected quite a bit and there is value at the current price, they only have a target of about 240. So they don't see much of a scope from here on. What they believe is that with the elections coming up, there will be some pressure on the marketing margins business. And therefore, they would like to remain neutral or underweight on this counter.
All right, that's the take coming in. HPCL, and it's clearly not reacting to the quarter gone by, but more so what the outlook is on up and about in trade right now. But let's shift gears then, and it's M&M, which is in top gear, and rightly so. Remember, it just came out with its tractor numbers earlier this morning, and the tractor sales have grown 17% to come in at 47,376 units. The tractor exports as well have been quite healthy at 1,064 units. Not just that, remember yesterday you had their overall sales rising about 13% to 55,350 units. So that has come in fairly strong this time around. A noticeable growth in the CV segment as well. And this has come in pretty strong. Moving right on then from M&M to Arvind, then let's talk a little bit about the F&O positions. Siddharth?
Well, you know, in a market which is going up and Nifty right now is 200 points up, we are seeing some of the stocks not doing so well, and Arvind Limited is one of that. We did see, you know, in the recent weeks, there was a smart bounce back from lower levels, but today, Avan, we are seeing formation of short positions, and look at the nature of fall, and there's no intraday bounce back despite market doing well. So the stock is under pressure and cash volumes are very high. So it is not just, you know, speculative shorts. I think there is someone selling in cash market as well, which is resulting into Arvind underperforming big time today.
Have it. That's the take coming in. 3% down. Arvind is certainly in focus. High volumes as well being seen in the cash market. Well, let's get in another auto stock, and that is Maruti. But let's understand what exactly the stock is showing by way of technical trends. Swati Hotkar with us on the show. So, Swati, what is your opinion? What does one do? Maruti has not been impressive when it comes to the overall earnings growth in terms of rather the auto sales numbers. How are you reading into the charts?
On weekly chart, if you look towards that, RSI is showing on the verge of giving the positive crossover from the oversold zone. So we have seen a lot of sell-off in this particular counter, but I believe that this selling pressure intensification will definitely come down, and I believe that this bounce back rally is likely to be continued at least 7,080 to 7,7120 odd level. So those who are looking for a long position, they can definitely build on at the current lit or any dips towards 6,980 levels. They can go for a buying position. For immediate target of a 7080, 7120 with a stop loss of a 6960.
All right, Maruti, 4% and counting. The take is that there is upside to the tune of 7,080 to 7,120. Mubina Trent as well is in focus. Let's talk a little bit about the earnings. Have they been inspiring or not?
You know, on the face of it, the numbers look like a mixed bag, and that's perhaps the reason why you've seen the stock price as well come off from the day's high. We have the revenue figure, which has been able to post a decent growth of approximately 90 odd crore rupees from the corresponding quarter of 522 crores. So now it's at about 616 crore rupees. Margins, however, have been okayish. In fact, they've underperformed. EBITDA, in fact, has the pace of growth in the EBITDA has definitely not been up to the mark when it comes to compared to the revenues, and hence you have seen the margins compress a tad bit. The profits have grown by 10 odd percent, so it's purely a mixed bag of numbers from trend, and that's maybe the reason why you've seen the stock come off the day's high.
All right, that's the view coming in on trend. So mixed bag maybe is how we can describe it. Meantime, IGL is a stock to flag off as well. What's the Nomura view, Pranay?
Well, what they're saying is that Gurugram, the fact that it has come under IGL's control now, brings about significant volume visibility, at least till FY25. The valuation for the same that it will be acquiring is something that will be determined by an independent body in a few weeks' time. But this is a big win and a shot in the arm for IGL. In terms of stock price, it's already rallied quite a bit. Therefore, you've seen the stock come off its opening highs right now.
All right, watch out for IGL at 284. Meantime, HDFC as well delivered its earnings, and you have Morgan Stanley reacting. They're very upbeat on the stock. They maintain an overweight rating with a target price at 2,400. Fairly aggressive. They assign a price to book multiple of 3x to the September 2020 BV. They say that a normalized ROE of 20% does seem fairly sustainable. So good going for HDFC. Let's move right on then, and Siddharth, talk about an OMC, another one. We flagged off HPCL, now BPCL. What are we seeing today with a nice 6% bump up?
Well, there's one common reason that crude oil prices are correcting, and that has a sentimental effect on OMCs, and that's the reason you're finding two names in today's session. But I just want to highlight what exactly is happening on the technical front. So stock has breached its resistance, which was around 304, or it is challenging that resistance, I would say. And at the same time, we are clearly seeing fresh formation of long positions, 12-13% rise in open interest. So that's a substantial rise. And needless to mention, if this kind of move happens, you would have high cash volumes as well. So in all fronts, technical and derivative, the stock is looking positive. Fundamentally, also, there is a reason because crude oil prices have crashed.
All right. Of course, it's the crude trigger that's keeping these stocks afloat. Fresh longs being seen in futures. Kunal, let's move on and talk about a heavyweight, another one, and that is ITC. At 282, the question is there going to be a spark of volatility? Are we going to see some sort of a decisive trend or not?
So, you know, a couple of days back, the stock was trading below its 200 DMA, and there were signs of, you know, swing breakdowns on the stock. And now when you see the stock price, it's reversed. And now it's trading above its long-term averages. And when you see the, you know, spate of all the large cap stocks, which have been bouncing back, you know, the chances and the probability is extremely high that even ITC could probably, you know, participate in this bounce back. I would suggest a buy above this breakout level of 285. Targets could be kept at 295 and stop loss around 278.
All right, watch out for ITC, 282 and counting. Meantime, it's a GSK consumer, Mubina, that we're flagging off as well. And it seems on the face of it like a fairly healthy quarter.
Yeah, that it certainly has been able to deliver. Mind you, GSK Consumer had been through a period of flux when it wasn't actually able to meet analyst expectations. But this time around, with the revenue growth of 14.4% as opposed to expectations with an 11% growth, margins as well have expanded from 23.3% to 27.8%. Analysts were expecting a margin figure of only 24.3%. So that as well is a big beat. And naturally, it has led to a profit growth as well, which has surpassed analyst expectations. The profits have come in higher by 43%. So after very long, you could say that GSK Consumer has been able to deliver on all counts when it comes to its second quarter numbers. And hence, rightly so, you are witnessing the uptick in the stock price.
Oh, yes, indeed. And rightly so, well deserved on all parameters. It's been a good quarter. Let's move on then. And healthy margins as well when it comes to SRF, Pranay.
Well, overall, very good results. Revenue has risen by about 49%. Profits are up 47%. So most of that growth has flown into the bottom line. If you look at the margins, yes, rightly pointed out, it's increased about 160 basis points to 70.4%. So segmentally, we've seen very good business across plastic packaging, as well as nylon tire, cord fiber fabric, and specialty chemicals, which has been a little soft. Their outlook is improving. But if you look at the stock, it's come off its opening highs. That's because it's already run up about 18-20% in the last few weeks.
Keep an eye out on this candidate as it's holding out smartly on the back of earnings. Meantime, let's also take in another set of numbers, and that is Greaves Cotton. In fact, it wasn't ideally the strongest set of numbers. It's been a little bit mixed this time around. You have the earnings which have come in. The profits have been very flat at 49 crore rupees. Top line growth has come in high by 9.5% at 495 crore rupees. The engine segment has been very good. It's been up at 468 crores, and that's supported your top line growth. Margins have been a little bit flat at 14.7%. They plan on evolving their mobility strategy. They plan a capex of 100 crores for the next 12 to 18 months. So lots of plans in place for Greaves Cotton. Let's move on then and pull up Balkrishna Industries, and clearly this is sustaining despite the volatility, Siddharth.
Yes, at least not today. You know, today markets are moving in unidirectional fashion, and 8 consecutive day, Avan, that the stock has closed in positive territory. Yes, some of the days would be like very marginal upside, but overall 8 consecutive trading session that stock is doing well. It has decisively moved above its 200 DMA, which is also a positive indication. And needless to mention that when such moves happen, long positions do get formed. So today too, we are seeing formation of long positions.
Yes, you sure are, and that's why the stock is active in trade today. Moving right on then, it's Vedanta. Let's discuss this one in greater detail. Swati, based on technicals we had, Gaurang recommend this as one of his wealth creation ideas. Do you believe that for the long haul as well, it's a good bet?
Yes, definitely. This counter is clearly looking wet. As of now, today it has given a positive crossover of 50 as long as 100-day moving average, which gives a positive indication. Also, the fact that the intraday, if we check the 120 minutes chart, yesterday it was just given a formation of an inverse head and shoulder, and today it has broken the neckline of a 217, and we have seen a very smart rally in this particular counter. So I believe definitely this rally is likely to be continued up to 240 to 245 levels. So one can take a long positions with a stop loss of 215.
Watch out, that's a view coming in on Vedanta. On that note though, we'll wrap it up on this show. Thanks so much for watching. Stay tuned, we've got Markets at Noon coming up after a short break.